In spite of the fact that he had a pretty good long NHL career, it's pretty hard to separate Fernando Pisani from his run through the 2006 Stanley Cup playoffs. Because Pisani was one of the big contributors to the Oilers going all the way to Game 7, scoring critical goals along the way, perhaps none more important than Game 5 on June 14th, 2006, when he scored shorthanded in overtime to save the Oilers' season. Now, when I think of Fernando Pisani, I think back to about a year earlier when he was at my parish church as the godfather for a baptism. His presence there, because we knew he was one of the Oilers, had this extraordinary effect on not only a number of my youth, but a number of my youth leaders. We had people going up and shaking his hands, myself included, people asking for his autograph. There's a couple of my youth that I remember were practically vibrating. They were so excited to see an Oilers player at Mass with all the rest of us. But it can be this way when we find ourselves around some sort of a superstar or celebrity. It can impact the way we see everything else that's going on. Now, when you hear the gospel this Sunday, which is the gospel that tells us of Jesus' transfiguration, meaning that Peter, James, and John got a taste of who and what Jesus really is as God, that he was transformed. He looked, he appeared differently in front of them. And he appeared with two of the notable figures from the Old Testament, Moses representing the law and Elijah representing the prophets. And so it shouldn't be surprising that as you're kind of hearing this particular passage, Peter is stumbling over his words to figure out what to say or what to say. Well, it's good for us to be here. Then he wants to build these tents to keep them there. Because when you're in a moment like that, you don't want to leave when it's just an ordinary celebrity, let alone when it is God. And it's, I think, made all the more poignant or all the more significant when you think about the fact that Jesus' glory was usually hidden. But this would be the sort of scene that for Peter and James and John would have just served to solidify what they were already beginning to realize. And that's something that we need to know too. That Jesus isn't just some rabbi. That Jesus isn't just some good teacher. That this is the beloved, only begotten Son of God. And that we should listen to him.